Dear friends, welcome back to practical session. I have already completed this practical code. I don't want to write this code as part of this video. That will take more time. I don't want to waste your time. Okay. This example, I like to explain using this pictorial diagram. I already explained these layers. In the Spring Framework, minimum will use them following layers: presentation layer, service layer, and data access layer. Okay, here each layer I have created as some Java classes. In the presentation layer, created a customer controller.java, employee controller.java. Then service layer, I created customer service.java, employee service.java. In data access layer, this data access layer, as of now we don't have a database concept. I have not started the JPS side, Hibernate side, so I am not using any database here. To handle the data, I created one component class, at component class, that class name is a data handler.java, data handler.java. Okay, see here the code. The controller have two classes, and handler package is having data handler, and service package is having customer service, employee service. I categorize these classes by package. Inside a controller package, my controller class. Inside a handler class, I have my data handler class. Inside a model class, I have two model classes, customer and the employee. Inside a service package, I have a customer service and the employee service. What is model class? Model class is a class which has only setter and the getters and the properties. When you look at customer, I have a customer ID, customer name, customer type. When you look at employee, I have employee ID, employee name, and department. Okay, the objective of this example is I want to fetch some customer information. I want to fetch some employee information from the data handler class. From the data handler class, user will input some name. The data handler user some input some name. Our service class provide that input to data handler. Data from the data handler, I will fetch the customer or employee matches with the name. That is the intention of this particular practical session. I used at service, at component, at autoware annotation. Okay. Now we're going to explore a data access layer. Okay. The data access layer, I used a data handler class. This data handler class annotated with at component tag, at component annotation. Annotated with at component annotation. Now this data handler class declared two variables, two objects. One is employee list and a customer's list. One is employee's list, another one is a customer list. This is the default constructor of data handler. Since this class annotated with at component annotation, whenever you start the Spring Boot application, this default constructor get initialized. This default constructor get initialized and invoke the populate customer data and a populate employee data. What is there in this method? The populate customer data, I am just initializing a two customer data, customer 1 and customer 2. Customer 1 dot set customer ID, customer 1 dot set customer name, customer 1 dot set customer type. And adding that customer inside a customer list, inside a customer's list. Similarly, I am doing customer 2 also. So whenever call this particular populate customer data, two customers added in your customer list. Okay, customer list object. Similarly, populate employee data, the populate employee data, I am populating the two employee data and adding that employee data in the employees list. Okay, so when server start, this data handler constructor gets started by the Spring Framework. Then through these two private method, I am populating employees data and the customer data. Okay, then there is a two method implementation part of this data handler, right? Part of this data handler, display employees, display customer. If you call display employees by passing any name, if that name matches with employee list, if that name matches with employee list, that name store into the separate list object. This is the implementation of this particular line of code. Using stream method, I am filtering the data from employees list that matches from matches with the name name variable. For example, if I pass in a name K7, if the employee name matches with the K7, if get employee name matches with the K7, that employee object collected by to list, then employee object then store it to result object. Okay, I hope this this type of code you should know, because I'm assuming that you already know Java 8 and Java 8. So this is a lambda expression. Through lambda expression I am filtering the iterating the list and matching the list with a particular name. If the name is matches, I am collecting that employee object to the result list. That's it. Similarly, display customer also. Okay, now this is the data handler. Since I annotated with at component tag, this particular data handler managed by your Spring Framework IOC container. Whenever start, this data handler constructor get invoked and automatically get populated by the Spring Framework. I am not doing anything. Okay, so this is the purpose of at component annotation. This is the purpose of at component annotation. When you any class annotated with at component, that class managed by your Spring Framework. I hope you understand about the data handler classes. Okay, now how we are going to inject these data handler classes in the service classes. According to this picture, if you want to display customer data or employee data, we are going to display through service classes, right? Through the service classes. Here we are. In the service layer, I created a two classes called service, customer service and employee service. If you want to display a customer service, we need to inject data handler class in customer service. If you want to display employee data, we need to inject data handler class inside a employee service through auto-wired annotation. Okay, let's look at the service class. Customer service. Since this class act as a service class, I annotated with add service annotation. Okay, so when you say add service annotation, whenever start the Spring Framework, Spring Boot application, Spring Framework finds these classes and put it in IOC container. Then customer service injected with data handler class using auto wire. When you say add auto wire followed by any class, that class injected in particular class. In our example, data handler auto wired with the customer service. So customer service can use hot data handler anytime. Whenever data handler need, customer service easily use the data handler. We don't have to use new operator. Okay, those things will taken care by your Spring Framework. Inside a display name, the customer service having one method implementation called display by name with a one argument. Okay, with a one argument, if you pass any name in this argument, inside this display name I am calling the display customer from the data handler class. So this display customer, what you will do, already we explained that the display customer return the list of customer that matches with the name. Okay, so that value written by this display by name, written by display by name method. When you see customer controller in this picture, customer, if you want to display customer controller, we need a customer service. So we need to inject customer service object inside a customer controller class. The customer controller class, I injected customer service using auto wire. This customer controller I used two annotation, at risk controller, at request mapping. At risk controller and at request mapping. If you say risk controller, this customer controller act as a REST web services, act as a RESTful web services. Whatever method I am implementing inside a customer controller, those method act as a RESTful web service method. Okay, each method I need to provide a unique URL. That unique URL I can achieve through the request mapping and get mapping. Not only get mapping, there are many mappings are there. Until I will going to cover the RESTful web service, I will going to show only the get mapping. Okay. Through these two annotation, I can tell what is the endpoint to access particular web service method. The display customer is my web service method. If you want to access this particular method from the browser or any other client device, you need to say HTTP localhost colon 8080, the port number, followed by what is the top level mapping customer. This I need to copy here. Then what is the method level mapping? This is the method level mapping. When you say like this in the browser, what will happen? No, then parameter, you can pass a parameter, name equal to KSO. When you say like this, this will call, whenever you type this particular URL in your browser, for Spring Boot application, invoke this particular method, display customer. Invoke this particular method, display customer. Then pass that value, the name value, the K7, name holds the K7 value. That value maintained here because I am mentioning request param inside the name. So we need to use that name here. Whatever name you are using, that name you need to pass here. That name equal to whatever value you want to pass. That value available inside the name variable. Then inside that display customer controller method, I am calling display by name method from the my customer service. This customer service injected by AutoWire in this class, so I can use it. Whenever call display by name, by passing this name, it will go here and call display customer from the data handler class. Now the K7 will go here. I am iterating the customer list through this code, through this stream method. Now the c.getCustomerName matches with this name, that customer object collected and stored to result object. Finally, matching customer information returned this customer list, available in this customer list that I am returning here. So this customer, this method return list of customer matches with the name. Now that list finally assigned to this particular variable. I am returning that list here. Your browser will display those customer, whatever customer matched that customer list displayed in your browser. Okay. Very similar in the employee flow also. Employee controller annotated with the REST controller. So this employee controller act as a RESTful web service class. This class implemented with a method called display employee. The display employee annotated with get mapping. Now the employee controller class level mapping is API/employee. The method level mapping is display. If you want to access this particular method in the browser or any other client device, we need to use localhost 8080 API/employee display. When you say this, that is API employee I am placing here, then the display I am placing here. When you say this, automatically this method get invoked. When you get invoke this method I am calling, this method is invokes the display by name method from the employee service. This employee service calling display employee from the data handler class. This data handler class having a logic whatever name popped here, that name matching with the employee list. If the name is matched, that particular employee object assigned to the result. This result return back to employee service. Return back to employee service. Now this employee service return back to employee controller. Now this employee controller, this returned value assigned to the result object, result list, this result list will get printed in the browser. Okay, this is the flow. I think you will understand that the flow everything, but one thing you don't understand, that is what is difference between add service and add component. What is difference between add service, add component? When you use add service, add component in your class, those classes managed by your Spring Framework. That part is very clear, right? But what technically, what is the difference add service and component? As per my understanding, there is no any difference technically for add service and add component. Both classes have some method implementation that methods reused in across the your application. That's it. Apart from that, these classes managed by your Spring Framework. You don't have to do manually call. Everything will happen through the autowire. Okay, this is the use of add service and component. There is no any technical difference between them. I will prove you that. First, go to data handler. When you look at here at component, this is the implementation of add component annotation. So they are saying public add interface component, then their implementation. That's it. This is the add component method. Add component annotation. When you look at add service, public add interface add service, this add service, this service annotation used add component only. Used the add component only. So there is no any technical difference between them. Both are the same. But standard purpose, we need to decide where you want to use add service, where you want to add component. Standard purpose, Java standard purpose. Let's say, for example, if you want to create any class name, you will start with class name through uppercase. Stop. Class name or interface, whatever thing you are creating, that name start with uppercase. That is a Java standard, right? Very similarly, in the project, if you are going to use in a service layer, if you are going to use any classes in a service layer, better use add service annotation. Better use add service annotation. And if any classes used by service layer, if any classes used by controller layer, if any classes used by multiple classes, those classes you need to annotate with add component, because that class act as a component class that code implementation reused in across in your project. So that class should annotate with add component. So you have to practice like this. Okay, in our example also I used it very similarly. See, the customer service in this flow, the service layer, I am using two service classes, customer service, employee service. So these classes act as a service, so I used add service annotation. Okay, now this data handler reused by two different service classes. Okay, one is customer service and the one is employee service. So this data handler class act as a component, so I am using add component annotation. This is the difference between add component and add service annotation. Okay, this is the time to run our example now. The data handler, I am populating two kinds of data, one is employee, another one is a customer. Okay, employee data and the customer data, these will get populated whenever we start the Spring Boot application. Okay, after implementation of customer data, I have not started my Spring Boot application work. So I'll going to restart my Spring Boot. Restarted, completed. Now I want to display my customer information. Okay. If you want to display customer information, we need to say It's restarting now only, I think. Restart is completed now. Okay, and I will going to execute the endpoint. So if you want to display customer information, we need to use HTTP localhost 8080 API customer / display, and we need to pass a parameter name. Okay, here I am passing a parameter name K7. Localhost 8080 customer display name equal to K7, but it's not displaying anything here. Why it's not displaying anything here? When you look at the data handler, go to the customer data. The customer data, the name I'm using Rajkumar and Kiran Ram. Either one I need to use. Okay, the K7 is not available there. So okay, now Rajkumar data getting displayed here. Customer ID 001, customer name Rajkumar, customer type seller. See, customer cuff 001, name is Rajkumar, seller. I want display customer 2. In such a case, you need to copy the Kiran Ram and pass here. The customer displaying here. Now I want to display employee information. For employee information, what is the endpoint? Employee information, this is the endpoint. Instead of customer, just you need to replace with the employee. Okay, see employee, customer, API / employee, then / display, followed by you need to pass name. What is the name? I want to pass Suresh. See employee name displaying perfectly here. Employee name, department is account. When you look at the data, it should be there. Employee name, department is account, department is account. Employee name is Suresh, employee ID is equal to 1. I want display K7. No, it's displaying here. Okay, hopefully you understand this entire session. If you're not understand, please raise a question, definitely I will answer you. If you like this video, please share it. Still, if you're not subscribed, please subscribe the video.